boots are made for walking, and that's just what they'll do. One of these days these boots are gonna walk all over you.
Right, a bit more knowledge is about the moon. And someone in the comments section, right, was saying, or paying us a compliment on one hand, and then saying, but the moon is not made of ice, right? And this is wrong, because the moon is definitely made of ice, right? Definitely made of ice. And this is not just my like personal opinion, that it's, you know, this is fact, right? And as we know, right, Mason's cured, you know, absolutely everything they put out, it's all coded, you know, dualistic codes, right? And they back up this sort of moon knowledge, right? You've got the pop group The Police, right, who had that sort of most famous single, which was Walking on the Moon, right, which was, you know, probably the most famous single, number one single in all the countries and all that, right? Walking on the Moon, see, by the Paul Ice, right? So the ice and the moon, right? So basically, you know, displaying the code in hidden view, right? And the two of the people in it, right, are called Summers, right? Summers, right? So there's the other code type of thing, you know. Your summer and your ice, right? So, you know, displaying the codes for all to see who are initiated anyway, see what I mean? And it's Gordon Sumner, right? Gordon Sumner, so it's like the summer plus the sort of summoner type of, you know, wizard ideas and warlock ideas and witches and craft ideas and all that, right? And there you got Stuart Copeland in the group, right? So it's like the police code ties in with the sort of cop. It's probably why they named it, you know what I mean? Yeah, it ties in with the cop, right? The Copeland, right? And they sort of say that these bands and that, you know, all these bands, like just, you know, group of young lads got together, started playing instruments and formed a band and all this type of thing. But of course, as we know, that's not the case. These sort of groups are sort of tightly vetted and sort of, you know, assembled by the sort of, you know, the brains behind them and all that. Right? And they look at Stuart Copeland, right, and his or her tea drinking father and all that, or mother, right, is Aaron Copeland, right? Aaron Copeland, who's like a big royal composer of music, you know, in a certain period, you know what I mean, towards the start of the 20th century, whatever, a big royal composer, you know what I mean, of orchestral music or whatever, right? And Aaron, see, so there's the Aaron, there's your sort of Levitical priesthood ideas again, right? So as we can see, the codes are tied together, right? And so, you know, this sort of moon is definitely made of ice. And that's not, like I say, it's not my personal opinion on it. It's like, you know what I mean? It's a fact. You know what I mean? It's displayed for all to see. So obviously, mankind never walked on the moon and all this. That was just basically a hex against the sort of Western-minded peoples. You know what I mean? The sort of non-Masons and all that. And of course, the idea of the rock and the sort of, you know, the moon rock and the sort of desolate, rocky place and all that sort of goes back to the scapegoat. So again, you know what I mean? Ties in with Levitical priesthood ideas. So, you know, as always, same codes are on display, just hidden in plain sight. And the moon is definitely made of ice, like the sun is made of fire and the moon is made of ice. End of.